Hello everyone, you are welcome to yet another video of Build Pro Global Enterprise YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be showing you how to import PDF into AutoCAD. There are basically three methods I use when importing PDF files into AutoCAD. The first one is through the Insert tab. Okay. Secondly, I just type import on my computer keyboard. And the third method is I use a command line, that is AutoCAD command line. Okay, I'm going to show you how to use all these three methods. Before we do that, let me quickly let you know the types of PDF files we have. The first one is Vector PDF. This is a PDF file made usually with CAD softwares like Revit, SketchUp, AutoCAD, etc. Okay. This type of PDF files comprises of lines, curves, objects, text, etc. The second type of PDF files is the raster PDF. This is a PDF file created from dots called pixels. Raster PDF files are created usually from snapping or scanning documents. Okay, like if you have an AutoCAD drawing that was printed on paper and you decided to snap it and convert it to PDF. Is an example of a raster PDF. Okay, or images created with graphic application software like Photoshop, Corel Draw, and the rest. So if PDF files are created from any of these application softwares, they are usually created as raster PDF. Now, without any waste of time, let me import these PDF files. I have the two types of PDF files on my computer, and I'm going to show you how to import the two of them. Now, to import PDF, the first method I told you is you go to the Insert tab on the menu commands. Insert tab is found right here at the top. There's something I would like you to know also before we continue. The ability of AutoCAD to import PDF into drawings is only obtainable in AutoCAD versions from 2017 upward. Okay, that is if you have AutoCAD 2017 version, 2018, 2019, 20, 21, and 22, you can be able to do that. But any version lower than 2017, those versions of AutoCAD can't be able to import PDF file. Now, after clicking on the Insert tab, you now come over to the Import group. This is the Import group we have here. This section is what we call the Import group. You have the Data group here. This line here separates all these commands into groups. Okay, this is the reference group, this is the block definition, and then this is the block group. So under the import group, where you have a PDF import over here, then click on this little arrow to have more commands. So you use this first one, we have the PDF import. If I click on it, a computer will now take me to the computer directory where I'll choose where I save the PDF file. Okay, if it's on the desktop or document, you look for it and open it. Now let me click cancel and go out. I'll show you the second method. The second method I said is you simply type import on your computer keyboard. So as I'm here right now, I'll start typing import, import, on my computer keyboard. The first option that comes up, I'll just click on it, or I simply press enter on my computer keyboard to accept the command. Let me click on it. If I click on it, I'll be taken to this directory still, so you can see I'm still at the same place. I'll now choose the PDF file and open it. And the third method is using the AutoCAD command line. This is the AutoCAD command line at the bottom here. I click on it, then I type import still, import. Now AutoCAD brings out commands that have that word import. Ensure you use the first one. Sorry, let me erase it and type it again. Import. Okay, I'll come over with my mouse and click on import, and I'll still be taken to the same place. So any of these three methods you can use to import PDF files into AutoCAD. Now, before I import this PDF file, there's something I would like to let you know. I'm going to click cancel to get out of this directory. You can see we have PDF import over here, and when you come over to the menu button, I'll do this later over here and click When you scroll down, you can see we have a import here and import PDF. Now this command is different from this other one that we have here. There are two different things, okay? This one we have here on the insert tab, you use it to import a whole or a complete PDF file into an AutoCAD drawing, okay? Or any of these other three methods I earlier explained. But this other import that we have here, you use it to import a portion of an XREF PDF file, okay? XREF simply means external reference. If there is a PDF file that has been referenced as an external reference to this AutoCAD drawing, you can copy a certain portion of it into AutoCAD, okay? Now look at it, if I click on this PDF right now, instead of being taken to the directory to import the file, you will see something else, okay? Now I'll click here, you can see AutoCAD is asking me to select the PDF underlay. So this is different from this other one. Let me hit escape on my computer keyboard to escape from the command. So take note of that. Now without any waste of time, let me go and import the first type of PDF file, which is the vector PDF file. To do that, simply go over to my insert tab here. I'm there already. Now click on PDF here. Now I'll be taken to this directory where I will choose where I save the file. Now I have two PDF files here. The first one is raster PDF and the second one is the vector PDF. Let's start importing it with the vector PDF. If I click on vector PDF here and now click on open, AutoCAD now gives me this. AutoCAD now brings me to this dialog box where I can make all the necessary changes to the way I want AutoCAD to import this drawing into my drawing. To import this PDF rather into my AutoCAD drawing. There are so many options here, but I'm going to lead you into the basic and the most important ones, okay? The first one is, we have under location here, specify insertion point. Always ensure you check this so that you can have the freedom to choose where you want your drawing to be inserted on screen. If you uncheck this, your drawing will be automatically placed if you click on OK. Okay, so always ensure you click on specify insertion point so that you will have the freedom to choose on your own where you want AutoCAD to insert. You have scale, you can give this drawing a scale, the rotation. How do you want AutoCAD to place it? You want to place it as it is, you leave it at zero. If you want it to be twisted to a certain angle, you give it the degree here. Under this other part here, ensure you check everything. Okay, layers. If you want AutoCAD to insert or import this PDF file with all its layers, you ensure you check use PDF layers. Okay, so I'm going to leave it at use PDF layers. Now, all these things are a bunch of settings that you need to do. Usually I check everything here. The only thing that I concern myself here is import as a block. If you uncheck it, this drawing will be imported as a native AutoCAD file, okay? Not as a block. You know, a block is a group of drawings, okay? Either lines or text or pictures that are grouped to act as a single entity, like a single drawing. It's what we call a block, okay, in AutoCAD. So if imported as a block, everything will be acting as a single drawing. Now let me import it as it is, then I also later import it as a block so you can see the difference. Now after making all the changes, I click on OK. If I click on OK, I'll be taken back to my AutoCAD drawing. You can see specify insertion point right there on my computer, on my mouse. Now click anywhere here and the drawing will be inserted. So you can see this drawing has been inserted, okay, but not as a block. If it's inserted as a block, if I'm to click on any part of this drawing, everything will be selected. It will be acting as a single drawing. But you can see that I selected this line differently from this other one, okay? I can edit and work on them separately. So it's not a block. It's imported as polyline. Polyline is a type of lines, okay, in AutoCAD. I already made a video on how to create polylines. I'm going to leave a link down in the description section. Check it out and watch how to create polylines. I'm going to hit escape on my keyboard. Now let me import this particular drawing again, but as a block. Now instead of coming over here, let me use the second method by simply typing import on my computer keyboard, enter import. Then I hit enter, okay, on my keyboard. So you can see that I'm taking to the same place. I'll still click on this vector PDF and I'll open. This time around, I'm going to check this box. I'm going to leave every other settings as it is, just like the former one. Then I click on import as a block and I click on OK. AutoCAD now takes me back to my drawing. I'll now specify insertion point, look for any convenient space and click on it. Okay, so the drawing has been inserted. But this time around, we can see if I hover over it, it's highlighting at the same time. Okay, the whole drawing is acting as a single drawing. If I click on it, you can see everything is highlighted at the same time, not like this other drawing. If I click on it now, there's a certain part of it. Okay, so this is the difference between inserting or importing a PDF file as a block and as a pure native AutoCAD file. Now I can equally convert an AutoCAD drawing that was inserted as a block to act just like this other one here by simply exploding it. Okay, simply click on it, then I type explode on my computer keyboard, okay, explode, then I press enter my computer keyboard. This drawing is now exploded. You can see it's acting like a pure native AutoCAD file. Okay, it's not acting as a single entity again. Now the last thing I'm going to do is to import another drawing, a raster PDF. Okay, these two drawings are imported from a vector PDF file. Well, let's see how a raster PDF file will act or behave when imported. Now I'll come over to my import tab here and click on it. Then this second drawing here, I'm going to import it, this raster PDF. I'll click on it and click open. This drawing over here is the same thing with this, but the only difference is this drawing was printed on paper before being scanned, okay, into this PDF. So it makes it a raster PDF, okay, it's not a vector PDF. I'm going to leave every other setting here as it is. Now click on OK and now specify insertion point and click on it. So you can see AutoCAD inserted this raster PDF. Raster PDFs, when imported into AutoCAD, act in the same way images or pictures do. So you can't edit raster PDF files as you would do with a native AutoCAD file. There are so many softwares you can use and websites to convert raster PDF files into AutoCAD file so it can be edited. I hope to produce a video tutorial on that soon. Please like this video if it was helpful to you and consider subscribing to the channel so you don't miss out when the video is released. Okay? So that's how to import PDF files, either raster PDF or vector PDF into AutoCAD. See you in my next video. Bye.